I've had some people complain that their flywheels had come loose. And guess what? Me too. So I took this whole thing out. This flywheel was loose on this shaft. And this flywheel was loose on this shaft. The set screws that hold this onto the shaft over here, they're pretty easy to get to. But on this side, you cannot get to them because the way that they've milled this out right in here is so that this governor can open and close. Part of the problem with the manufacturer on these, they do not machine a flat on this shaft for the set screws to seat. And when I remove these set screws, this will turn freely on the shaft, but I cannot get that off of there. So in the process of those working loose, and this thing being turned by an electric starter, whatever, it has milled some swarf and groove in the shaft, and to press that out of there is just gonna tear things up. So I just went ahead and I tightened those up the best I could. And you wanna use a good Allen wrench. You do not wanna use your $3 set of Allen wrenches from Harbor Freight. You want something that's a good quality Allen wrench like Bondus. And make sure that that's all the way down inside that socket before you go turning on it, because you do not want to tear up that socket that's on the set screw. This also gives me a chance to show the bearings that the crankshaft runs on. These are little roller bearings, little needle bearings. And I suggest if you take this apart, you put the caps back on here the way you found them. I put a black mark on here so that the bottom end of the connecting rod goes on the same way I took it off. You need to remove these flywheel weights so that these arms come away from the hub. And then loosen these two screws, this one and the one on the other side, so this can slide back. And these arms will come out here far enough to where you can reach in here with an Allen wrench and tighten these up. You want to tighten that up quite firmly, but don't get too carried away. You do not want to strip out that set screw. Before you put everything back together again, you want to make sure that these arms are operating full range. This follower has to be in that groove. This piece of brass goes all the way up against the inside of the flywheel, and you snug these up. Remember, this is brass, so you don't want to over-tighten it. And there's one on each side. Make sure these two bearings are centered before you put the caps on. The end of that shaft is recessed on this hub to provide enough clearance between here and this follower. If I hold the exhaust valve open and I move these governor weights out, and this arm, this blocking arm, comes in here and holds the exhaust valve in the open position, and I want to have clearance here. And when that exhaust valve returns, there needs to be a little bit of clearance between this blocking arm and this piece right here. And you can hold one of the valves open, the intake or the exhaust, and just rotate this and make sure everything's turning freely. In my case, this disc that has the magnet in it for the Hall effect sensor, it was too close and I had to move it over a little bit. That magnet that's in the disc here currently is right about here, and I'm coming up on compression. I want this to fire just a little bit past top dead center. So you'll just have to play with that until you get it correct. In my first video on this engine, I explained how that timing worked, and you go back and review that. When one of these flywheels comes loose from the crankshaft, it's going to do some damage to that crankshaft. And in my case, I could not get either one of these flywheels to come off easily. So I chose not to do that. Just the process of removing it is going to tear up that shaft even more. I just went in and made sure that these set screws were good and tight. And you need to check these every once in a while. It's going to be very difficult to check these frequently because all of this mechanism is in the way. So you may want to decide not to use the electric starter to start these engines. This flywheel had moved in on me. And I had a hard time getting that shaft back recessed like it is now. When this was removed, I supported this across a piece of pipe and let this hang free. And I beat on that crankshaft with a wood dowel, and I was using a wood mallet to do that. You do not want to beat on this with a metal or even a brass punch, because you're probably going to mushroom the end of that shaft. There's a good chance this engine will then become a paperweight. I tried to run it, and it would fire a few times and then stop because this bar didn't have enough clearance that was holding the exhaust valve open. So all you have to do is loosen these on both sides and then move this out a little bit, which will slide this a little bit closer to the engine, and then retighten those. I've oiled the heck out of everything, so it's going to throw oil. I've got it on this nasty old tarp.